Previously unpopular.
My quarterback's not starring in your musical, Vincent.
I can stay on the team and do the musical too.
Why don't you just admit it? You think you're better than me. The truth is, you're not.
I think you should leave.
And if I don't?
Dad!
Mom?
What the hell's going on here?
What is that on your finger?
We're engaged. Good morning. Sam, what's this?
That's Joe McPherson, my dad, your high school sweetheart. Remember him?
Sam, I'm not trying to replace your father.
I know you're not, because you can't.
He's gone, Sam. He's not coming back. Do you know that since your father died, I have spent every night tossing and turning on his side of the bed? I haunt the closets. I smell his old shirts. And I cry.
This won't last. Just remember when I warned you about this family, the apple doesn't fall far from the tree.
What is your problem with Brooke McQueen? Sam, please, will you help me understand?
Okay, fine. Mom, you want a hit list of her good qualities? She's heinous. She's vain and passive-aggressive and judgmental
and pious and hypocritical and judgmental. Sam McPherson is heinous, Dad, and I'm warning you, watch out, because those qualities are taught.
I love Jane Brooke. She's not that way.
You don't even know her, Daddy.
Honey, for the first time in 10 years, I felt something romantically. I thought I'd forgotten how to feel that.
It's 8 years, Daddy. Why can't you just date like a normal person?
I'm gonna take this slow, Brooke, I promise.
Oh yeah, Daddy, real slow.
You know, should I skip school today, Mom? You know, so I can make the noon wedding?
This is new territory for all of us. We're gonna get through this.
Together. And we'd like to start by
throwing a little dinner at the end of the week. Right? It'll be fun, don't you think?
We'll think it over once or twice. We'll last the longest in this life. Character or rock hard size. In the end, do you believe that lies in what you see? 'Cause if you do, then baby, you've been deceived. Well, me.
Thank you so much for moving your schedule around today, Miss Esposito, so we could have this little talk about your amphibian fetish. I know you probably had to tear apart your file of facts to fit me in between the raids at all the animal testing centers, and I appreciate that. Let's start off with some typical glass candor. You're gonna lose this fight, miss. No one has ever gotten beyond week 2 in a dissection protest in my class.
Respectfully, I repeat my position. I will not dissect that frog.
Wonderful. In that case, here's what we're gonna do. Your moral beliefs clash with my teaching style, so my frog is gonna clash with your outfit. Now that you have your fine, stylin' frog purse, not only can you wear your heart on your sleeve, but also your disruptive stubbornness.
And I suppose this punishment ends only if I take out this sad little soul and slice him up?
I'm too sexy for your party, too sexy for your party, the way I'm disco dancing.
Mary Cherry, what are you wearing?
It's a cocoa mink with chinchilla trim. I'm breaking it in for fall winter.
Are you kidding me? It is criminal to wear fur. To make that single coat, over 175 minks were anally electrocuted. That's torture.
No, that's fashion. Well, my, my, looks like Mommy packed your lunch today. You animal rights activists sure have yummy diets. Excuse me.
Since Jezebel brought it up, have a name for your little clear bag of courage?
Jehovah. He's my witness against conformity. Mark my words, by the end of the week, my slice and dice nightmare is over. Sammy's writing this brilliant Animal Farm-esque editorial about how the food chain's fading because of frog harvesting. Glass has got to pay attention to that, right?
Yes.
Everybody's staring at me like they were at that fur freak, Mary Cherry.
Could it be because, oh, I don't know, you're wearing a dead frog?
Look, I will gladly endure the stares piercing me like arrows if my accessory activism saves even one tadpole.
Oh, hey, speaking of endurance, did you talk to Sammy this morning?
Mm-mm.
She has to sit down with Brooke McQueen and family Thursday for a dinner. She's freaking out over it.
Shush.
Yeah, guess what they're serving? Frog legs. Oh.
Hey, people, listen up. The first order of the day here in humanities class is take out a piece of paper. Now, I want you to do exactly what I say with no deviations. Take out that sheet of white, fold it. Keep on folding it until you have 16 perfect, pristine squares. I assume everyone knows what a square looks like. Now cut them out. Don't stare at me like a bunch of retardos. Make some squares.
Do it.
Have you counted up 16? You should know how to make squares by now. Thank you. Now then, put your squares to the edge of your desk facing the aisle. I mean perfect. I want to get some paper cuts when I pick up your stack. Center, people, center. Thank you.
What's up?
Thank you. Now then, will somebody mind explaining to me why you let me waste your time without calling me on it? And while you're at it, will someone please explain to me how you can let me call you retardos? That's prejudice. I know, I know, I know I am intimidating because I dress fantastically. But you have to listen to that little voice inside your head that said, hey, teacher lady up there is acting a little whacked. Is she on crack? What is this fish doing? What is this little fish doing?
Swimming?
That's right. That is right. He is swimming off to become an individual. Swimming off to become an individual. Listen to your instincts, people. Learn to recognize your own voice. It is the most important voice you will ever hear. So now everyone, turn your desks towards each other in pairs, facing each other. We're just gonna do a little experiment on how to learn how to listen and communicate, great. Now, what I want you to do is learn how to hear your own voice by learning how to listen. And the way that we do that is by role play. So for the next 30 seconds, I want you to look into your partner's eyes and speak in their voice.
Look, we both know that this thing with our parents is never gonna last.
Yeah, you got that right.
Well, because my dad is gonna wake up and come to his senses.
Interesting, and this would imply that my mother's not good enough for him, is that it?
Sam, I don't know anything about your mother, except for the fact that she moves fast.
Excuse me, but your lounge lizard father is the one who booked this last-minute trip on the lust boat.
Failing your anger management class, Sam? That's probably because you don't like your life very much and you wish you had a better one. Your mom probably feels like she needs two parents to control you. I sympathize.
You know what? Someone should throw a telethon, the profits of which would be used to restore your humanity.
I'm cooking dinner on Thursday night. Is there anything special I can whip up for you? Eye of Newt, perhaps?
You know what? Anything Barbie works up in our easy bake oven will be just delicious.
Good work, people. I felt a real sense of communication going on here today.
Nice to smell you all this morning. Okay, guys, let's get down to brass tacks. Mr. Vincent here has called this meeting. Coach Preddy, he feels that you are torturing Josh Ford in inhumane ways to push him towards leaving the musical. Is this true?
False.
Josh, did Coach Preddy give you that watch?
That's my watch.
I loaned it to him to help him with his scheduling.
Oh, drop the act, Peretti. How could you possibly afford a Rolex on our salaries? Everyone knows you've got your jock alumni cronies on the school board to bow to your every secret whim. You've been moving around funds for years.
I think the lady does protest too much here.
That phrase denotes your guilt, numbnuts!
Josh, what do you want? The musical or the football team?
Well, I'm sorry, but I love football. But I also love to sing. So, actually, I'd like to do both.
Then you will. Thank you, Josh. Could you wait outside? Mr. Vincent, I do not want you coming in this office again, whining like an adolescent because you didn't get your way. I will not have you fighting over a student to resolve your high school dilemmas. You will both work this out.
God, Cole's lip gloss is so genius.
You know, I should just send them an 8x10 glossy and save them the trouble. I mean, look how obvious they are, just staring at us.
Coveting our lives.
Our men, our plastic surgery. What? It's no big deal. I just had a rib removed.
Sammy, piercing. Rudolph the red nose no more.
Yeah, heal quickly.
You know, Carm, the more I think about it, the more it makes me so mad you didn't make it.
Cheerleading system is this elitist 1950s tradition run by pampered bottle blondes. The whole system needs to be overhauled, starting with Brooke McQueen.
Okay, Cujo, back in your cage. Sammy, listen, I know you feel like she attacked you in humanity.
She did. She basically said I wanted to be her.
I wouldn't mind being her for a day. It is my dream in life to wear a belly shirt.
But why don't you look at this Thursday night dinner thing as an opportunity? If you and Brooke can become friends.
Oh, never gonna happen. No. Nope.
Hear me out. If you and Brooke at least became civil, maybe you could stop all the stupid animosity that exists in this school. And Lil, love ya, but that damn frog is spicy smelling and you've got to do something.
Sorry, not cutting it. Don't worry, Jehovah.
Yo, Nicole, those are some fat snaps in your wig there, baby.
Thank you, sugar daddy.
My queen, as requested, your king brought to the banquet table. So y'all make peace now.
Wanted to tell me something?
Yeah.
You guys, I have an announcement.
Oh my God, yo, Brooke's pregnant.
3 weeks from this Friday, I'm going to have to miss the away game at Nixon High. I'm missing this game because today I bought out a front row for the Kennedy Fall Musical starring Josh Ford.
Really?
Yes.
Count me in, too.
Oh, me three. It sounds like fun.
Yeah, I'll call in sick for that game. Gotta support my boy.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I've got 3 days to stop this dinner from happening. 3 days and counting.
I just need to get through this week, get this dinner over with, wait for my dad to wake up, and I'll be fine. I'll be right back on track. It'll be great. Mine. Hello.
If you want the story of your career, meet me in the mall parking garage at dusk. Level B2.
Who is this? What's this about?
You can call me Deep Throat. It's about Brooke McQueen.
Are you alone?
Deep Throat. Sir Vincent?
Hello, Miss McPherson. I'm quite a fan. I was very intrigued by your column, the one on popularity at Kennedy High. Gripping. If they gave Pulitzers for the team beat, you'd be podium bound.
This is so cool, but I don't follow. What does this have to do with Brooke McQueen, like you said?
I could only read between the lines of your report. As for your interview with Miss McQueen, delicious, subtle, vitriol. We seem to have the same perspective. I could help. Take this.
Contropartie's fiscal budget. Not for distribution, do not photocopy. How did you get this? Why don't you take this to Principal Hall directly?
Well, Ms. McPherson, you of all people should understand my dilemma. Nobody listens to you if they think you have an agenda, do they? And as for Miss McQueen, you may want to pay special attention to page 5, the cheerleading budget. I scratch your back. You scratch mine. Oh. Miss McPherson,
not the beret.
This is amazing.
Oh my God. Have you read the newspaper this morning?
No, no, not yet. Why? What's it say?
Honey, it's a complete vendetta against you.
The Kennedy High Glamazons have finally gone too far.
She's out of control. But what I didn't know is the cheerleaders have a Prada allowance. What's Prada?
Only the most stunning of designer fashions. How do they expect us to do our split kicks without Prada space boots?
I'm glad somebody finally busted them white bread rah-rah girls.
Nick, I can't believe this. Read me the Carmen part again.
Carmen Ferreira, who all agreed had the best audition for the 99 squad and yet was cruelly overlooked. I am so mad at you, Sam.
But why?
Well, before you made me your poster girl for the Brooke McQueen Haters Club, you should have asked my permission.
Okay.
Even though I'm depressed and feel life has no meaning since that editorial, this restroom always makes me feel so pretty. Why is it so non-teen, lavatory, luxurious?
Some fan of that 1950s movie star Kim Novak redid it in her honor in the 60s or something.
Y'all, I'm so nervous. You just know the school's gonna shut the cheerleaders down now.
Well, if it isn't Lois Lane.
How convenient for you that the in shade of blush for fall is Bruise.
I got through grunge in a Vanilla Ice concert in the second grade. Not afraid of you guys.
So who's your hidden source, baby cakes? Who leaked that secret budget?
I'll never tell you that, Blondie. It's my First Amendment right as a journalist.
Well, let's see what ink tastes like, Tippy Typewriter. Brooke may be too much of a lady to bring you down to size, but I'm not. So let me fill you in on a little secret around here that nobody knows. My middle name, Payback.
What's going on here?
Nothing. We were just talking.
Ladies, Miss McPherson printed the truth.
Well, there are two sides to every story, Mr. Grant. Or didn't they teach you that in community college?
Thanks. I was beginning to feel like I was in an all-girls prison movie for a minute.
Well, the truth is a wonderful thing, Sam, but it doesn't always set you free.
You leaked the budget, Vincent. You broke in and you stole my private files.
Coach Peretti.
Cecilia, that's two steps to the right and one forward, babe.
Oh, pooba. Coach Peretti. I know you're here. I smell brute. Somebody read the newspaper editorial to me, and I am outraged! I have taken your budget for the rest of the year and given half of it to the drama department!
What? You can't do that! My program can't survive on that!
Better win homecoming.
This is better than Judge Judy.
Traditionally, when the pride-filled big bucks come rolling in. Good day.
FYI, Franny, just so our schedules are synchronized, I've moved the date of the musical to homecoming weekend. Josh Ford will be missing Friday's game. Best of luck.
I'll get you for this, Vincent.
Huh?
show has that dinner party coming.
Actually, it's really great. You know, I was thinking about using your article for placement so that my dad could see exactly what kind of person you are.
Brooke, I know it's hard for you to believe that the world doesn't orbit you, but that editorial was written out of obligation to the truth.
Obligation to the truth. That editorial was completely unfair. I can't believe that there's actually a time that I thought we might be friends.
You never thought that, did you?
Well, I guess you'll never know now, will you?
Oh, I cannot believe I almost got sucked into your gravitational pull.
Oh, Ginger, Marianne, we're not at home watching Ricky Lake talking back to the hoes and freakouts. Shut up and get Dyson. Oh, and Miss Lily, the weather report just arrived and there's an F5 tornado swirling around your GPA. You gonna fly up there and join the trailer park people in the eye of the storm? Or are you gonna cut croaky and fall safely to earth in my strawberry patch?
Respectfully, I choose to keep my purse closed and daydream.
Great! Just checking. Enjoy your F. Back to work, everybody!
God, I wish I was Pam Grier. I loved all those blaxploitation movies in the 70s. Back then, you could be a real heroine and people would listen to you. And if they didn't, you'd kick their ass.
Run the animal rights editorial like you said you were, maybe you could...
Okay, Lil, I get it. You're mad because you have to carry around the frog tote. You know, Harrison's right. It stinks and it's only gonna get worse. Why don't you just cut it and move on?
Because maybe I have a conviction that means something. That's from a true, positive place. And yeah, you're right, Sam. I am mad at you. Maybe if you had listened to reason and run the right editorial, you could have saved lives instead of just yourself.
Wait, why do you think Coach Pretty wanted to meet us here?
My God. Nick Stone Cold Foxboy is walking straight for us.
Nick, he's naked.
Hey, Nick. Is this some new benefit that the cheerleaders hand out towels now?
You know it. We're full-service gals. And you're full-on Italian, aren't you? Nick.
Yeah, that's cool. That's all right.
Hey, ladies. Glad you can make it. Sorry for the exotic location. I needed to keep this private. Unfortunately, I got bad news. I'm gonna have to shut down the cheerleading squad.
Because of Sam McPherson's editorial?
Yep. I'm gonna have to shave the budget to make ends meet. Glamour's the first thing to go.
Well, no, there's gotta be something that we can do.
Bake sales? I could auction off a couple dates.
There is one thing you could do.
Just read me the lines. You're pausing too much. I can't concentrate.
You need to spice it up, man. Take that homegrown Nelly, dip her, slip her the tongue.
Dude. Hey, babe. You look upset.
I am.
Yeah.
All right, I'm out.
All right.
Bye.
What's wrong?
They're thinking of canceling cheerleading.
Ouch. The editorial, huh? Well, hey, it's okay. We've got each other again, and that's what's important. So, is there anything I can do to cheer you up?
No, I'm okay.
A back rub?
No, I'm fine.
Take you to the movies? Anything?
Quit the musical and play at homecoming. Coach Peretti says that if we make a good show at the game, that we'll get donations and we'll get the cheerleading funding restored. I mean, he said we'd save a lot of jobs, too. Josh. God, I hate asking you this.
Yeah. Especially after you made such a big show out of supporting my decision in front of everybody. God, Brooke, you should be in the musical. You're the actor here, not me.
Maybe we should get that laminated. You know, so it doesn't fade away.
It's fading away more and more, Harrison. The memories I have of him are just like outlines, and I have to color in the detail or something. God, I miss him. My dad would understand what I was doing running that editorial.
Sam, I think you ran that editorial because you don't want him replaced. You want your mom to think Brooke McQueen is superficial and horrible, so she'll call off this engagement.
My dad always said reporters follow their instincts.
You have a hidden agenda, Sammy. The funny thing is that everybody can see it but you.
Whose side are you on anyway?
Hey, Cyclops. Stridex called. They said stop using our product or we're gonna get sued for false advertising.
Hi, baby. What's wrong?
I never should have listened to Coach Peretti. I can't believe this.
Well, we know who to blame, don't we? McBitch McPherson.
You're so right. She's taking everybody else down. I mean, she's not only hurting me, she's hurting you. She's hurting the school. She's hurting Josh.
Plan B.
I can't do that, Nick.
Honey, you don't have to. This is a role I was born to play.
I hope you realize the gravity of your charges. And if I discover that you're lying, it's an immediate expulsion.
Principal Hall, how could you possibly think that I would make something like this up? I mean, the very fact that this hidden shame has forever soiled an innocent, petal-fresh friend of mine who's too confused to come forward herself. Well, I'm just devastated.
Very well, Miss Jillian. I have no choice but to take action.
Every good journalist feels like they're going through a war alone at one time or another during their career.
I just feel like you're the only one I can talk to. You know, the only one who understands. What?
Often in cases of sexual misconduct, the student has mixed feelings about telling on the teacher. If the teacher is popular, there could be repercussions when and if the students find out.
Principal Hall, do you really believe that I would allow myself to stoop to such behavior? This is a witch hunt. This is an athletic department attack.
Mr. Grant, I am well aware of your character and your background, and I am also aware of the statistics. 89% of these allegations are proven untrue.
Mr. Grant is a great teacher. He would never hurt me. We went out to dinner one time.
Mr. Grant, you are aware that any outside activity with a student has to have a parental permission slip. Is this slip on record? If it is, it will go a long way to validating your claim of complete innocence.
No. No, I did not get that.
Mr. Grant, I'm so sorry.
So am I, Sam.
Stop the presses. Was just delicious. I don't think I will ever look at another pork chop again unless Brooke makes it. What would be the point?
Jenny? No, you have like this, just a little piece of gristle. Just it's on your it's on your upper lip. Now give me here. I'll get it. So this was fun, guys, huh? Dinner in the kitchen family style. A guy could get used to this.
You know, it was fun. I felt like I spent the evening with the Brady Bunch or the gang from Different Strokes, sort of like an episode of those Families in Turmoil thrown together shows that always got canceled because one of the kids robbed a dry cleaner to pay for his drug habit, or else the premise just ran out of steam.
So, Brooke, which one of the girls on the bunch did you always relate to?
Oh, Brooke's a Marcia.
Don't you think, Brooke?
Actually, no, Sam. I'm a Chan.
Well, which one are you, Sam?
Oh, can I guess? Judging from the outfit, I'd have to say Alice.
No, I'm a Jan too, Brooke.
Really? What a coincidence.
Okay, I think I'm just gonna clear the dishes. Sam, you barely touched anything on your plate here.
Oh, I'm a vegetarian.
Since when? You eat hamburgers and stuff.
Since I took my first bite of those pork chops.
Brooke, the dessert in the oven smells absolutely delicious. What is it?
Thank you. It's a souffle. It's a very delicate French dessert that's hard to make because of its temperament. Any unnecessary disruptions and it'll collapse. It was my mother's recipe.
Sam, how's school today?
Oh, it was good, thanks. Mom, Principal Hall will probably be calling you tomorrow. My journalism faculty advisor got framed for sex with a student, the student being me. Don't worry, I'm innocent, as is Mr. Grant. Nothing happened. Brooke here just decided to get back at me for writing my editorial and made the whole thing up.
I didn't do that. I don't know what you did last summer, and I don't care. You'd like to think that I had something to do with it because it would make your life a little easier, because then you would have someone to blame for your problems, when your problem, Sam, is yourself. Now that you've ended cheerleaders and my relationship with my boyfriend, maybe you can find some time to grab some therapy. You need it.
Sam, are you having any problems at school you want to talk about?
It's none of your business. You're not my father.
Sam. I don't like your tone. It's not respectful. I'm not going to tolerate it.
Excuse me.
Don't.
What are you doing, Sam? You're spying on me.
Are you looking for some more filthy dirt you can fling around in an editorial?
No. And Brooke, you just have so many nice things, and there are so many people at our school who have nothing but their pride. And every day you chip away at it, you take that too. When is enough enough for you?
Just get out, Sam. And FYI, put away your mental tape measure, because you are never moving into this room or this house, you or your mother.
My father died 2 years ago. Did you know that? My mother loved him very much. Did your mother die?
No. She left.
With you as a daughter, it's easy to see why.
Dinner last night that bad?
Yeah. It was pretty brutal.
Okay, whatever. You know, I'm a bad person. I have vendettas. I suck. I've hurt.
Wow. Dinner was that bad, huh?
Look, Sam, what we wanted to say to you was that we are so sorry.
What?
Yeah, you should have listened to us as your friends. But hell, we should have listened to you, too. Yeah, I didn't make stupid cheerleaders. And it was a blow. But you lost your dad. Doesn't really compare.
Sammy, when Harrison told me how upset you were, I was totally shocked. Why didn't you tell me?
I didn't want you guys to think I was a big baby.
Sammy, look, this Brooke McQueen thing, you think you're alone, but you're not. You have friends who care about you. They want to help you through this situation, if you'll just let us.
Thanks, guys.
Okay, so, what do you guys want to do tonight?
We could rent A Bug's Life.
Watch Sugar Ball like a baby again.
I can't help it. They're just so small and helpless.
So, I have an announcement to make, everybody. I'm not gonna be able to make it out tonight. It's just that, all week long, you know, I've been hearing these voices in my head from my dad, my coach, my mom, my girlfriend. And, I think what I need to do is just take a while to clear all the voices out so I can hear on my own.
I deserve it.
I need your eyes this morning, Mr. Vincent. Tell me, what do you see?
I see a man. A man who goes to the gym. Creeping around in a dark room.
Oh, how intriguing. And what is he wearing?
It appears to be a catsuit.
Designer?
The International Mail Catalog.
And what is this glamorous burglar doing?
A little cats to limber up. A little Lord of the Dance.
Fabulous. And now?
It appears to be taking a vial of some sort.
Which does not belong to him?
Yes.
And that would be a
felony.
Mr. Vincent has resigned, my children. Effective immediately.
Celia, 12 o'clock.
Oh.
Honey, get a guide dog.
Bobby?
Yes, Obi-Wan.
Tell me about Lily Esposito. Your bio class had their first pop quiz on amphibian anatomy, didn't they? How did Miss Lily score?
Yeah, 98%.
That is wonderful. Now you can cease and desist your frog purse torture. We're here to encourage a child's spirit, not abuse it.
Yes, ma'am.
Principal Hall, there's a catchy song title that I can't get out of my head, and that song is Hot for Teacher.
Yeah. Hey, what's up with Luke Grant and Sam McPherson? I heard you caught him in the act.
As for Mr. Grant, I am 100% convinced that all will turn out well. Coach Peretti, you are to refrain from treating Josh Ford as your personal yo-yo. And give a listen to the South Pacific libretto. It's all about the power of tolerance.
Look, I'm sorry I slapped you.
No, I deserved it.
When I got home last night, my dad was a wreck. He was just sitting in his chair, watching his favorite The Best of Johnny Carson tape.
Yeah, I know. All my mom said to me this morning was a very distinctive hurt thanks. I didn't listen to her or how she felt.
I guess they really love each other.
Yeah. And then there's you and me.
Two people who really don't like each other at all.
Well, this ought to be interesting.
Very.
I'm really sorry you didn't get a choice. Thanks for giving me one.
Last rites?
Yeah. A moment of silence, please.
I wanted to tell you I really respect you for what you did. Not caving in and cutting them all up, I mean.
How's the whole big dilemma going? The team and the musical.
It's tough going. Every second of every day is like this superhuman effort not to cave into what people want me to do, you know?
Don't cave. Stay true to yourself and what you want.
Yeah, I don't know how long I can make it.
Actually, it's the only way to make it.
Bye, little dude.
Godspeed.